You're inside KDAY's community show. Your issues, your topics, your community. Now here's your host. Here's your host, Classic One.
Classic One.
Classic One.
Classic One.
It's the 93.5 KDAY Community Show. Your boy Classic One in the building with my co-host Trey Vaughn. I'm going to throw it to you, my man, because you're connected with today's guest. Why don't you go ahead and introduce
What's up with you, brother?
Man.
I got the pleasure of introducing one of the greatest show on turf members, Mr. HAKIM, along with his man, Mr. Legend, in the building for today's community show. What's going on, Mr. Oz? What's going on, Mr. Legend?
Bro, Shot, just
What's
chilling.
What's up, KDAY? Legendary. What's up, fellas? How you guys doing, Trey?
Man,
what
we doing
up, Oz?
We doing good,
oh,
brother.
Oh, man, blessed.
We definitely want to appreciate you taking the time to come out here and join us on the station. So for the people that don't know, why don't you give a little introduction about yourself?
Well, first and foremost, I like to thank everybody in the Los Angeles community for their support. Once again, this is your boy, Oz HAKIM, one of Cali's finest, Young Fairfax High School Lion graduate. I'm out here, class of 94, went to San Diego State University, majored in child development, played pro ball for 10 years, won the Super Bowl, played in 2 Super Bowls. Blessed enough to talk to KDAY today this morning. How you guys doing?
Man, we doing
good,
baby.
Real good.
Super Bowl champ, bro. Did I leave that out?
Leave what out?
I said, did I leave that out? Super Bowl champ, though.
No, no. Let me clarify that.
I don't got no sound effects in here. We were going to get it in.
1999, Super Bowl champs, Oz HAKIM had his greatest game on October 3rd against Cincinnati. Four touchdowns. Come on, man. I know this game.
Big time. Big time.
That was a beautiful
with the San Diego State got drafted.
I think it was right off of the water in Cincinnati.
Yeah.
And every time Kurt Warner or every time I put my hands on the ball, it was like quick six. Like,
no.
Don't even worry about it.
The highlight was when you
–
I don't even know if you remember when you grabbed the ball and then you pushed the old boy in the back of the head.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the game.
First of all, when I was coming off the line of scrimmage, I remember it like yesterday. When I was coming off the line of scrimmage, he was kind of holding me, and the play wasn't even to me. Kurt Warner just saw that it was the free safety was out the middle of the field, and he saw it was one-on-one. And I caught the ball over the shoulder, technique catch, of course.
Yeah.
right.
But at the same time, I was kind of ticked off because he kind of was holding me off the line of scrimmage. So when I caught the ball, I had the opportunity to mash his head down.
Yeah, to do him wrong.
Walk in the end zone. You know how we do it, West Coasting.
Yeah, West Coasting. But I'm going to take it back a couple years before that. San Diego State, a lot of people don't know, you was in that Heisman hunt for a minute.
I was there, so I know what was going on. Like,
but you was in that Heisman host for a minute.
In the 98 draft.
Yeah, yeah.
Like behind Randy Moss and Jack.
Yeah, yeah.
Williams.
A lot of people don't know that.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know. You know, I went to a small school, San Diego State, and I played in the Senior Bowl, and that's where I got a lot of my credibility. That's where a lot of scouts really see me in action. I actually started the Senior Bowl, me and Hines Ward, and those were some good, positive years, man. Like, every time I look back and reflect back, thank God, you know, I played the game for the love of it. But at the same time, when you win a Super Bowl, that's a whole nother level. You know what I mean?
A whole nother plateau.
Incredible.
I got you.
Good everywhere. Everybody knows.
Yeah, exactly. But we definitely want to point out the reason why we got Mr. Oz HAKIM on here, besides he's a Angelino, is he got a camp going down June 17th at 1500 West Washington Boulevard at West Adams Prep High School. You can get more information at gobeyondthegame.org. So I've been there numerous years. It's definitely something you want to come out to, get the kids out to. And we gonna make an effort to get everybody we can out there, brother, because like I said, I've been there, and it's definitely a great organization.
Absolutely, man. Being the Legendary and Intellect, Love, Mercy, you know, Foundation, we out here, we trying to get it. We trying to make a positive impact on these kids. We trying to go beyond the game. You know, I'm retired now. I retired in 07.
Okay.
I played with the Las Vegas Locomotives last year, won the championship.
Okay.
But at the same time, I'm retired. My cliques is on the shelf. I just want to give back to the community and give back to the youth. You know what I mean? I majored in child development, and I'm one of the ones that care. So I want to get out here and get in the community and let them know that this is what it's about. You know what I mean? Life after football, but still, life skills And when I say go beyond the game, we're going beyond the game. Game meaning gratitude, attitude, motivation, and education.
Yes,
and it's
sir.
A blessing. We got some great volunteers that come out and help us all the time. We got great sponsors. I love it. You know what I mean? It's an opportunity of a lifetime. We got, like you said, it's going to be at West Adams Prep High School. It's going to be from 9 to 3 p.m. The age is, 6 to 18. And we're going to have workshops, SAT, ACT workshops for the high school kids. We're going to have some gang intervention workshops. We'll have guest speakers coming in, speaking with the kids. It's a great positive movement. And I would love everybody in Los Angeles that's down with Go Beyond the Game or just down with the positive movement that I'm trying to bring to the community, you know?
Definitely. Oz is your man, Classic One, bro. I think it's real dope that you're utilizing, you know, your major in school, you know, to give back to the community and you know, not just having it and not really utilizing it, especially with all the experience, life experience you have, things you can show these kids and ledge. You can jump in anytime here. How long have you guys been doing this camp or, you know, how long have you guys been running it?
10 years, baby.
Well,
we're 10 years strong.
I know Legendary.
Strong.
He could tell you firsthand. He's been at every one.
Oh, yeah.
And I think we're going on 8 or 9 years
this is
now.
10 years, bro. Shot.
That's all right.
Off like the last couple years, but we back in effect. I want to bring this back in the community. This is what I love to do. This is my passion, and I just want to get back in the community and just show everybody what it's all about. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah, that's huge, man. 10 years, 10 years long, 10 years strong, and more years to come, man. Any specifics that you want to bring up from past camps, good examples of things, like things that might have touched you or impacted you from giving back so much?
One of my my first Go Beyond camp, I had the experience to not necessarily coach, or I don't look at myself as a coach, maybe a role model, but I had the opportunity to coach up the young great Long Beach Philadelphia Eagles, Deshaun Jackson. He came to my first Gopi Army camp, and it's, ever since then, it's been a success, you know?
Oh, yeah.
It's not just football, you know what I mean? We're trying to teach life skills with this program and let these kids know there's somebody out here that really cares about them. And, you know, we just want to get in the community and show our love and give back and support, you know?
Definitely, man. That's big. Les, what were you going to say, man?
You know, this is Legend. You know, right now I'm president of Field Operations Public Relations. And we've been doing this now for 10 years, since 2000.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, my greatest moment for me is, you know, seeing my son come up from the beginning to now. He's going to be, you know, coaching and helping out with me and Oz and Naeem Shaw. And it's just a pleasure just to see him just come up through the ranks like this. And I always like that we've always kept our price low, mm-hmm. but we always got the fresh jerseys.
Always.
Fresh jerseys.
They got the fresh jerseys,
and
fresh
camp,
t-shirts.
Period.
Oh, yeah.
The hot lunch. I done been to many camps. They got hot lunch. It's going to hell.
Yeah.
Keep it quiet, though. The only reason why our camp was kind of delayed because we want to make sure we bust with the fresh jerseys this year.
Exactly.
So, Rat. You know, we always got the fresh bags, you know. And I just like the cats that come out, like Oakland great Willie Brown. He saw what we was doing. He wants to come out. Just like, man, I'll be there. And we have Marcel Reese. He'll be starting fullback for the Raiders this year, number 45.
Oh, yeah.
He'll be at the camp this year.
Another thing they have, man, when you go to these camps, most of these camps only have maybe like the guy that's playing, hosting the camp. At Oz Camp, I've been numerous years. He got almost professional at every set of drills.
Oh, yeah,
And it's amazing as a parent, as a volunteer, you're just out there, you're like, man, this is spectacular.
Mm-hmm.
So it's definitely something you should go to. If you're joining us now, it's the KDAY Community Show with the Legendary Legend and his
Super Bowl champ.
Hey,
one of the greatest the members of the greatest show on turf, Mr. Oz HAKIM. If you don't know, it's gobeyondthegame.org, 1500 West Washington Boulevard. Bring the kids out from 9 to 3 p.m. is something you don't want to miss.
It's going down. Believe that. With or without. But we would love you guys' support because we can't do it without you guys. You know, and like you said, we've been doing it for years now. And the show must go on. You know what I mean? Game meaning gratitude, attitude, motivation, education. Bring the kids out. You never know who's going to show up at my camp. You know what I mean? I have
surprises
covered from everywhere. It might be an entertainer. It might be an artist. It might be... You never know.
Yeah.
You never know.
That's what's up. Oz, since you retired, man, you got a lot more time on your hands. It's good to see you utilizing it well, giving back to the community and kids. But you also opened up a beer establishment in 09?
I started my